Welcome to the product tutorials on how to add a new user in Replicon. I'm now logged in into the Replicon instance. In this video, we will explain how you can add new users within the Replicon system. In order to add new users in Replicon, go to Administration and click on Users Available under Employees and Organization. Click on the Add User option available on the top. On the Add User page available here, add up the first name, the last name if you would like to. You will see the email address populating automatically. You can, however, go ahead and manually change the email address. Input an employee ID. If your organization has opted for multilingual support, then you can choose from the language that you would like to assign to the user. Input a start date. The start date can be backdated or future dated as per your requirement. And put in an end date if you would want an end date to be put up for this user. You can choose the login name as per your requirement and choose to disable the login if you would not want the user to log in to the Replicon instance right away. Now provide a password and then check the force password change on next login if you want the user to change the password as soon as he logs in to the Replicon instance. If you uncheck this, the user would continue with the password that you have set up for the user. We recommend that you check this option. If you would like to add a supervisor, then click on Add Supervisor option. Choose a department. And now choose the hourly payroll. The initial payroll by default will always be zero. If you would like to edit the initial payroll, then click on Edit Historical Payroll option. When you click on that, you would get an option to edit the initial value of that hourly payroll. And then click on Done. If you would like to add a payroll for a future dated, then click on Add Payroll option. Choose a date when you would like the payroll to be effective from. And then choose the amount. Once you're done, click Done. Now choose the employee type. These employee types will be available based on what's been configured in your system. And finally, add the overtime rule if you want to. Once you have added all the details, click on Save User Profile option available at the top. Save User Profile takes you directly to the license page. Here, you can assign the license that you have purchased from Replicon to this particular user. My licenses available here on this screen may differ from what you have bought, as this is a trial that I have configured. Next, go to Roles and Permission. Make sure that you at least assign a basic user or a report user permission to the user, and then choose any other permission that you would like to for that particular user. Once you have assigned all the permissions, save Roles and Permissions. Now move over to Groups if your organization has opted for Groups, and then assign the group based on what's been configured in your system. Move over to the Punch Entry Policy if your organization uses the In-Out Time format for the particular time entry. Now you can choose the Punch Entry Policy based on what's been configured in your system, and set up a default activity if the default activities are available. Click on the Save option and the Punch Entry Policy would be assigned. Move over to Timesheet. Most importantly, assign a timesheet template to users. Choose what will be the timesheet period type. And finally, choose the approval path. You can choose the validation rule here, which will be applicable on the timesheet. And then choose the activities that the user would be working against. These activities can be configured within the system. Once you're done with changing, click on Save User Timesheet Settings. Move over to the Time Off section if your organization uses Time Off Recording. Now choose the Time Off template, choose the approval path and choose the time off types that you would like the system to be configured for. And click Save Time Off Settings. If your organization uses expenses, then go to Expenses and assign an expense template based on what's been configured in your system. Moving over, the next is the Schedule option. Under Schedule, you would find the time zone that has to be allotted to the user, the work week that the user would be working for, and the holiday calendar that will be followed by the user. Here, you will also assign if the user is working on an office schedule or a shift schedule. Once you're done with the changes here, go to the Payroll tab, where you define the pay rules for the system. Next is the billing and cost. You can define the default billing rate for the user, the hourly cost, the cost normalization if you would want to. Now moving over to email notifications, you can choose which notification should be received by the user, and you can choose which notifications are to be configured for the user. This is how you can set up a new user in Replicon. Thank you for watching the video. Did you know that you can now get in touch with Replicon using Replicon Community? In order to access the Replicon Community, go to the Replicon website and click on Customer Zone. On the Customer Zone, choose Community and you would be taken to the Community page. Now you can sign in or register and start posting your questions, queries, ideas, bugs, issues, and one of our product management team members or one of the Replicon representatives will get in touch with you immediately.